Good afternoon. Today I'd like to talk about walls and gratitude. We're talking about walls or a disconnect. In my example, I would say a disconnect from my passion or a real lively feeling about life. You have walls and you're disconnected from your gratitude. And you're probably being mean to yourself, because you're not grateful, saying, oh, I should be grateful. This is the example I would like to talk about. Let's backtrack and start at the beginning. Honestly, genuinely, authentically, how do you feel? Let's not judge it. How do you feel? You don't feel gratitude. You feel a disconnect or a wall. Excellent. We know where we're starting from. Now we have something we wish to solve. We want to be connected, passionate about our life. I'd like to start with an example to show you what gratitude is. Two children are given a beautiful present. The first child politely says thank you as they're given the gift and sets it on the coffee table and heads off to do something else. The second child takes the gift and says not a word. Off they go and open up the box and start to assemble and play with the building toy, and you hear the laughter and you see the light in their eye as the awe and the wonder of discovering an amazing toy and an adventure they're having. They didn't say thank you, but you can see by their action they delighted in the toy. It satisfied. They did the action of grateful. Now let's take a more adult example. A woman sees a very beautiful dress in the store and it looks magnificent on her. She purchases this dress, takes it home and hangs it in her closet, so grateful for it existing, but she doesn't put it on. She doesn't use it. It doesn't make any significant difference in her life. It didn't make her feel more passionate. It didn't make life more satisfying. She truly was not grateful for the dress, for she never wore it. She did not do the action of gratefulness. Why is this? She didn't really need the dress. It wasn't the item that would satisfy. She didn't know herself. This is a great place to start. Your disconnect and your wall is actually from knowing yourself. Could that be you? So how are we going to get back to connecting and finding what satisfies and what we would truly be grateful for? May I suggest a very simple breath, a large breath in, and letting it out is a connecting with you. Now let's say that single breath is not enough this time to get you connected with you and you need something more. Then may I suggest a walk in nature where you feel your feet as they touch the ground. You hear the birds. You feel the wind. All of a sudden you're connected to your body. Then you're also connected to what will satisfy and what you will truly be grateful for. I'd like to give an example of this in my life. What I really wanted was to spend time with my two gentlemen, my husband and my son. And I wanted to have Japanese sushi food. We found the restaurant and we went. We were excited for the new adventure of trying a restaurant. The last one we loved closed down, and we were looking for a new one to meet this need. We were excited. The tea came. We were enjoying it, enjoying each other, chatting about this and that, and having a marvelous time. As each piece of food came, we were sharing the little pieces so everyone could try everything as it came. We were laughing and chatting, and I was grateful and satisfied. This is what I truly needed and wanted, and because it satisfied, I was grateful. So listen, if you do not feel grateful or satisfied by something, is it because it wasn't what you really wanted and needed? Or is it because you have something to heal inside of you that keeps you from what you truly desire? Figure it out. Go and see something, someone about it, or spend some time doing natural healing in you. As often, if I can be of service, a gentle bear of healing, I'm here. Go out and enjoy and find out what truly satisfies and build the grateful in your life.